Hey everybody, thanks for coming to the channel. So today I tried the Wild Edge Berserker saddle and Steppladder system for the first time going up a tree with my bow. I had worn it a couple of times just to help hang some hang-on stands using the lineman's belt and getting up into a tree very low and not trying to bring my bow up. But today I went up a tree for the first time and I made a lot of mistakes. And I think it's important for you guys who are looking to get into saddle hunting to see these real experiences. Like, you're not going to get into a saddle, climb up a tree and be a pro right away. So I want you to come along that journey with me. So this is the first time I've gone up a tree with my saddle. I brought my bow, I took a couple of shots with it, made a lot of mistakes, I wasn't happy with it, but it just goes to show you I'm going to have to practice a lot. It is a steep learning curve. You're not going to just get into a saddle and be comfortable the first time you do it, so you have to practice before you go out and hunt with it. But I want to show you guys that all uncut, and we'll, highlight the mistakes that I made along the way. This is also a awesome shirt from Wild Edge, who makes a saddle that I tried out. Even if you don't want to get into saddle hunting, the shirt's pretty cool. Check them out. www.wildedgeinc.com. Let's get into the video. tell you what, if you can hear me down there, it's my first time climbing this way. And it's pretty intimidating, actually. Never thought I had a fear of heights, but being up here in a new, you know, a new way to climb, a little bit different. This step I put a little higher than the other one because there's a hump on this side, so it's making it feel a little bit different when you're climbing it. I'm going to put another one of these up. That's not going to be great for this. If I had knee pads, this would be a lot easier too. I got bad knees.
All right. Can you see this opening in the tree here? You know, dead scar from something. It's got brick. You know, it's got bark on the you know, sides that kind of cave in. That just created this, made this step when I was standing on it. Put some pressure on one side, it caved in one side of that bark a little bit and just moved it a little bit, and I don't like that, so I'm gonna try the perch down here, and next time I select the tree, I'm gonna do one that's not half dead. Come on. Didn't mean to do that. I was supposed to keep one of those to attach my tether. Well, I guess it's better to do it anyway. I'm hooked into that step. Should be up here as I'm doing this, but I don't recommend that. Don't drop all your steps. and do this all one-handed. Now I want to get this tether, tree tether. Bridge and unclip the bridge from the step. Okay, the moment of truth. Not gonna lie, that's pretty scary the first time you're trusting it. Oh, it still feels good. It does. Should have brought my bow hanger. Rangefinder has no battery in it, idiot. That shot was rushed and low. Again, guys, I went into this blind, apart from tying a few steps on the tree and wearing the saddle, kind of just using it as a lineman belt to hang on stand. I haven't been up in a tree, haven't done any of that stuff, so it's going to be a learning curve for sure. But like with anything, you're gonna have to practice and practice and practice. Get comfortable with it. The knot tying on the steps is actually very easy, but you're gonna have to figure out how to pick trees better. You know, look for things in trees you don't want like that. I honestly don't like having my bow hanging off the back of me here. I just feel like something can break. I'll probably use a pull-up rope next time. A couple good shots on that deer, but I think that last one is terrible. I was just rushing, but you gotta practice.